The brilliant, the wonderful, the talented Mr. Peter Kendall Clark.
As some of you know, I live just around the corner, not quite on the street where you live, on Hicks Street at the Mansion House, and my wonderful friend and neighbor, Marcy Chapin, who is my godmother and producer, she kept saying to me during the lockdown, Peter, you should come out and sing during the 7 o'clock applause for the healthcare workers. And I was like, Marcy, it's the last thing I'd ever want to do in my life. But there's Jeopardy at 7 o'clock, of course, you know. And Alex Trebek wasn't well at the time, so I was committed to the Jeopardy. Finally, one day I did it. It was May 1st, 2020, and people kind of liked it. And so I just started doing it, and I did it 100 nights in a row. My friend Magee Hickey covered it on the news, and the next thing you knew, I was like kind of a thing. And the New York Post called me the Brownstone Baritone. I was getting much more media attention than I ever had for 40 years of doing theater and opera. Much more for singing karaoke show tunes on a stoop in Brooklyn. And I wrote a song about it, and I'm gonna do it for you right now. I'm just, let's start again, because Ellen and Al, my friends Ellen and Al just hopped in. just the brownstone buried, walking off my tired feet, scouting Hicks and Henry Street to put on a show. Ignites a spark at the watermark at Brooklyn Heights. Someday maybe Jesse Green will give a nod. Heck, I play the promenade to be in a show. Say, Mr. Producer, I'm talking to you, sir. I don't need a lot, only what I got, plus a Bluetooth speaker and a crowd that's hot. Brownstone Barry, teaching at a private school. Kids of glitterati who put me in their show. You think, Lena? Brownstone Barry, tracks, stating on my income tax that I made no dough. Then, in the pandemic, I got a mention in the post. I mean, the quarantine was just the scene to make me the toast. Deborah Norville said I'm magic on the stoop. Then Magee gave you the scoop. Now this pink canary's gonna rock your sanctuary on the Brownstone Tonight. Today's a little bit of a neighborhood concert, and I have a couple of guest stars that I literally run to on the street regularly. And the first one is, who are the people in your neighborhood? In your neighborhood, in your neighborhood. Magee is a person in my neighborhood, and I run into her on the street each day. Come on up, Magee Hickey. Come on up, Magee. Oh my gosh, what do you got there?
I'm a very old TV news reporter. Oh, but I can do the skits.
Magee, come on here. Come into the light. Let the light find you. Magee doesn't know this, but I knew who you were for years because we had the same hairdresser.
Gemma. I've got so many.
Gemma.
Oh, yeah.
Gemma had super cuts for 20 minutes. So I would come in, I was like, it's the lady from the news. It's the beautiful redhead from the news.
And it was always natural until it wasn't.
Like so many things. Listen, Magee is a wonderful flautist, and she's going to do the for real. Right, so right. She's going to play for us. But she also has a little song that she likes to sing that's kind of introducing you to her if you don't know her. Magee, I'm going to let you take it away.
Thank you so much, Pita. So, about 10 years ago, I decided to face a fear and try to sing. I actually took up the flute because I was from a singing family, and I couldn't or was scared to sing, and I thought, okay, if I put an instrument near my mouth, I won't have to sing a song. Then my mother passes away, and I all of a sudden get attracted to cabaret, and I think, oh, I want to do this. So I have two dear friends in the front row here, Larry and Shelley Strickler, who have been on my journey. I took a cabaret class at the 92nd Street Y to face my fear, and then a mutual friend of ours, a TV news writer at Channel 4, decided to rework some lyrics. I'm always on the brink of retiring because I've been doing this for 41 years in New York City. And I have worked at all of these stations, three of them twice. I used to be really embarrassed by that because it meant like I couldn't hold down a job. Like other people, like a Channel 7 reporter, Jim Dolan, just retired, he was there for 35 or 40 years, and I've been doing it for 41 years, but I've been at Channel 2 twice, I've been at PIX 11 twice, I've been at Channel 7 once, Channel 9 doesn't even exist anymore. I was at Channel 5 before it was Fox. I've just been everywhere, you know, and I was at New York 1 and CNN for a weekend. So anyway, it just keeps going on. So about 10 years ago, when I was approaching 60, age is a feminist issue. So now part of my honesty moment is I'm approaching 70. So I'm going through the same dilemma. As I was approaching 60, I thought, wow, everybody I work with is half my age or younger. And I work with these cameramen who say, I'm worried about my mother. I have to move back to South Dakota. And I go, Benton, how old is your mother? And they go, 55. She's in the prime of her life. You don't need to move back for her. But anyway, so now as I approach 70, I'm still in the same dilemma. So my late friend Bob Wiener reworked the lyrics to this song, and I hope I can remember it. I've been singing it for 10 years, but you know, as you get older, it's not always there. So I do have the words there, but then I have to put on my glasses at the last minute. But anyway, here's to you, Bob Wiener, my parents who encouraged me to be a performer, whatever it was going to be, and I'm just so happy to be here, and I'm so happy that Michael asked me to be here, because he is the definition of kind and caring. And anyone who wants to help out with Alzheimer's awareness. And I keep promising you I am going to bring my flute and play in memory care. We will do that. But anyway, take it away. Accustomed to my face. I used to make their day begin. They've grown accustomed to my hair, my wild Irish flair, my smiles, my frowns, my Q scores up and down. I can't believe I'm working still. Some say I'm too old to fit in. Yes, it's true, I was an ingenue. Remember way back when. And in my heart I know I'll never look that way again. Yet they're accustomed to my name, accustomed to my hair, accustomed to my face. Now we switch my. I can see me now, PIX 11 local news, at a fire scene where smoke has gone away. I can see me now at some silly live remote, wondering why I have to work on Christmas Day. In a year or two, when my freelance days expire and my station's ratings really start to sink, and my agent calls and says I should retire, and my friend suggests that I should go rethink. But I'm the real ambitious type. The sort who doesn't quit, gives a shit, loves the attention, and doesn't mind the hype. Ambitious type. So I will never go away. I will pretend that I don't care. What the critics might reveal won't reflect the way I feel. I am real, just like the color of my hair. Magee, not in TV news. Ha! good, the bad, the sweet, the sad, are all the things I want to tell. If not, my life would be like hell. I am a very good reporter. I'm so glad I'm on TV. I am a person I hope that people always want to see. They've grown accustomed to my sight. I'm somewhere on the air. Devil is my live shot. And we thank you, Bob Wiener, for those words. Woo! And I'm still working Christmas Day.
Thank you, Magee.
Thank you for inviting me.
And I'll see you in a minute.
Yes,
you'll be back with your flute.
Yes, I will.
Well, I decided to show this, call this show Autumn in New York, and that is a reference to when I first moved to the city. I moved to the city in 86, and I was a big fan of Mr. Mel Torme, aka The Velvet Fog, and my college friends and I would go every fall, every September, to see Mel Torme sitting. He did a sit down at Michael's Pub, and it was always Autumn in New York with Mel Torme, and I'm so nostalgic about it, and I wanted to do that tune for you. For sure, and that led to ideas about all the incredible songs about New York. So this evening's program really is a little bit of a love song to New York, our favorite city. It's time to end my lonely holiday and bid the country a hasty farewell. So on this gray and melancholy day, I'll move to a Clark Street hotel. I'll dispose of my rose-colored chattels and prepare for my share of adventures and battles. Here on the subterranean floor, looking out on the city I hate and adore. Autumn in New York, why does it seem so inviting? Autumn in New York, it spells the thrill of first nighting.
Castle in Spain. In your neighborhood, in the neighborhood, Rebecca's a person in the neighborhood, and I ran into her on the street 2 days ago. Come on, Rebecca. Okay, Rebecca is one of the stars of St. Anne's School, and I met this little girl like over 20 years ago. You're like a fourth grader in my, or third grader in my fifth grade violin class, something like that. The cutest little girl. She could already play violin, she could already do ballet, she could already do everything. And we worked together all through high school, and Rebecca started in a lot of shows at school and was a really accomplished triple threat, I think, already, you could tell. She could sing, dance, and act, and also play the violin. And I don't know if you know this, but Rebecca went to Yale, and her first semester at Yale, I was on a class, I had gone to the Metropolitan Opera, and I ran into one of your professors. There was actually like a class trip. And we started talking about you and said, who is Rebecca Brudner? I mean, she came here and she got the lead in the musical, and she also got the lead in the opera. It's like, we've never had anyone like this. So it was like, yeah, we have a lot of them like that at St. Anne's. Anyway, Rebecca's special. Rebecca is an actor, she's a working actor, and we have a special connection in this part of my life because the very first time I performed in front of the Mansion House, I put up a thing on Facebook saying, oh, I'm gonna get up and sing tomorrow, and Rebecca said, oh, I wanna come sing with you. And of course, it was the pandemic, and so everybody's, all our actor friends were out of work, and people were really eager, just, oh, let's get up and sing outside, that will be fun. So I had a friend walk from Bushwick just to sing on the wall. I mean, I had friends from Broadway, from opera, everyone showing up, but Rebecca was the first. We got up there with our masks, and do you remember this? We stood on the wall, here's, go away, to show, all the way. This is what 6 feet is.
Yeah.
And I know that was a hoax. That was a made up thing, 6 feet. It wasn't real. But we were honoring it, and we performed 6 feet apart on the ledge. And gosh, doesn't that seem like a lifetime ago?
It was a lifetime ago.
And in the meanwhile, I run into Rebecca's mom on the street. She keeps me posted. Rebecca got a gig in England, right?
Yeah.
And tell us about it. Okay, so pick up the thread.
Okay, so I first moved to England for grad school, actually, and then have since worked out there performing around the UK, and recently came back to New York for the foreseeable future, mainly because I miss my parents. but I've been performing and also running a music nonprofit that works with pediatric patients to help them write and produce their own music. Mm-hmm. So as we're all here celebrating another amazing organization tonight, I thought I would mention.
What's your nonprofit?
It's called Hear Your Song. It's something that I started when I was an undergraduate and is now a 501c3 nonprofit.
That's wonderful. How can people find out about it or support it?
Yeah, you can find it at hearyoursong.org. And you can listen to lots of great songs that have been written by kids and teens in New York and all around the world.
I love it. Well, listen, this is a number that we did before. I think we both... we both appeared in the musical Guys and Dolls at some point. I was a senior in high school. I was a little slimmer. Those were my dancing days. And you did the show in Summerstock?
Yeah, I did it, yeah. A couple years ago in Summerstock.
Anyway, we're gonna bring it together. I love this song. It's like a love song about the beauty of New York in the early morning. It's called My Time of Day. My time of day is the dark time, a couple of deals before dawn, when the street belongs to the cop and the janitor with the mop, and the grocery clerks are all gone, when the smell of the rain comes up clean and fresh and cold. And the street lamp light fills the gutter with gold. That's my time of day. My time of day. And you're the only doll I ever wanted to share it with me. That's my real name. You're the first person I ever told that to. I've never been in love before. Now all at once, it's you forevermore. I've never been in love before. I thought my heart was safe. I knew the score, but this is wine that's all too strange and strong. I'm full of foolish song, and out my song must pour. So please forgive this helpless haze I'm in. I've really never been in love before.
Now all at once it's you forevermore. I've never been in love before. I thought my heart was
special thanks to another former student and current colleague of mine, Mr. Dov Liebowitz. No, back in the back. Will you stand up? When Dov was in fourth grade, I'll never forget, we had our first choral concert and he brought me flowers. I was conducting. I was like, who does that? It was so sweet. And anyway, Dov is responsible for slightly softening up what was a very harsh light. And Magee and I both thank you for that. Yeah, it's like, just a little softer. St. Anne's did a production of Saturday Night, which was Stephen Sondheim's very first musical, which was slated for a Broadway production that fell through. It wasn't produced until some years later, but St. Anne's did it. And I remember Rebecca was in it, I think, when you were like 15. Mm-hmm. And this is such a wonderful song from it. It's another kind of love song to New York. It's called What More Do I Need? You want to do it?
I'll do it.
Do it.
Let's do it. Once I hated this city. Humid and gritty, what a pretty town. What thought I could be duller, more depressive, less gay? Now my favorite color is gray. A wall of rain.
But did a summer stock production of Fiorello.
Yes, we did.
Sheldon Harnick and Jerry Bach's Fiorello, which is about Mayor LaGuardia. And I must have been in the Berkshires or something, and I don't even know how it happened, but they ended up dropping into the Classic Stage Company, that space in the East Village, and doing like a 6-week run of it.
Yeah, we did like a
like the CSC
run.
Happened to be empty, they dropped in. The next thing you know, it's like, New York Times color picture of Rebecca. It was like, how did this happen? When she's really on the fast track. And I got a ticket. It was hard to get a ticket. And I remember it's a thrust theater, and I was like way in the back. It's like the theater's there, and I'm way in the side. But I'm watching Rebecca sing, and I could see her parents in the front row, and Sheldon Harnick was right behind them. And I was like, this is all too much for me. It's so incredible. And you were singing that song,
When Did I Fall in Love?
And I'm thinking, this song's so beautiful. I think the character's about to die. So it was too much for me. Anyway, Rebecca, please come back all the time.
I'm happy to, yeah.
Stay in the neighborhood. Keep you close. All right, so Matt is incredible. Matt Pod is is part of a band called Mimi and the Pod Brothers. Matt has an identical twin brother, Adam, who is also an incredible musician and arranger.
He looks like this.
He looks like that. I say Matt's the cute one. They're both incredible, and they have this band. They play multiple instruments, and Adam also sings, and they do it with Mimi, who is an incredible singer. She is an opera singer, but she also has this kind of Sarah Vaughan like switch that she turns on. And you got to go hear them. They're incredible. And I've had the pleasure of jumping in for a couple numbers with the band, and frankly, that's all I ever want to be doing, is just getting up in, you know, hotel lobbies and singing numbers with their band. Matt's very gifted with putting together a medley, and I thought, Matt's going to be here, we got to do a medley. So this is a medley, it's really fresh as my morning coffee. We just put it together, because I had so many New York songs I wanted to sing, so let's cram them together. So should we do the big New York medley for them?
Let's do it.
Let's do it.
Thank you.
to get away, take a holiday from the neighborhood. Hop a flight to Miami Beach or to Hollywood. But I'm taking a Greyhound on the Hudson River. I'm in a New York state of mind. Summer journeys to Niagara and to other places aggravate all our cares. We'll save our fares. I'm a cozy little flat in what is known as Old Manhattan. We'll settle down right here in town. We'll have Manhattan, the Bronx and Staten Island too. It's lovely going through the zone. It's very fancy on old Delancey Street, you know. The subway charms us so when balmy breezes blow to and fro. And tell me what street compares with Mott Street in July? Sweet push carts gently gliding by the great big city's a wondrous toy, just made for a girl and boy. Turn Manhattan into an Isle of Joy. Isn't she a beauty? Isn't she queen? Nicest bridge that I have ever seen. Her paint's a little tattered where age has shown its touch. Still, I guess I'll always love her very much. Like the folks you meet on, like to plant my feet on the Brooklyn Bridge. What a lovely view from heaven looks at you from the Brooklyn Bridge. I love to listen through the wind, through her strings, the song that she sings for the time. I love to look up at the clouds in her hair. She's learned to wear like a crown. If you've been a rover, journeys and lies over the Brooklyn Bridge. Don't let no one tell you I've been trying to sell you the Brooklyn Bridge. All the folks in Manhattan are sad, 'cause they look at her and wish they had the good old Brooklyn. Nothing but the Brooklyn, good old Brooklyn Bridge. NYC, what is it about you? You're big, you're loud, you're tough. NYC, I go years without you, then I can't get enough. Enough of cab drivers answering back in language far from pure. Enough from Frankfurters answering back. Beat of
dance in glee. It's sung, I love the melody of 42nd Street. Little nifties from the 50s, innocent and sweet. Sexy ladies from the 80s, who are indiscreet. They're side by side, they're glorified. Where the underworld can meet the elite. Naughty, body, gaudy, sporty, 42nd Street. Come along and listen to Lullaby of Broadway. The hit parade and ballyhoo, the Lullaby of Broadway. The rumble of the subway train, the rattle of the taxis, the daffodils who entertain, and Angela's at Maxie's when a Broadway baby says goodnight. It's early in the morning, Manhattan babies don't sleep tight until the dawn. On the weekends, and this is actually the first time that we've gotten to do something together, and I'm so thrilled. We've been talking about it for years.
About 4 years, the pandemic.
About 4 years.
You on the ledge.
This is a piece that it's very nostalgic for me. It is by Claude Bolling. I had the vinyl of this, and it was recorded by Jean-Pierre Rampal. I feel like this is like, imagine you're at brunch in 1978, and this is the soundtrack. It's this wonderful suite it's a jazz suite, and the movement they're doing, it's, what's it called, blues and baroque?
Baroque and blue.
Baroque and blue. So we go back and forth between a little bit of a classical world and a little bit of a hop world. But why don't you come, center?
But I just want to give such a huge shout out to Peter, who's so magnificently singing, and Matt, who I just said, oh, I'd like to do baroque and blue, and he goes, okay. It's not that easy a piece.
I've got the blue part figured out. The baroque is...
Who knows? what will happen with me. But the point is just to keep going. I could use anything as an excuse, but
thank you.
Oh my gosh. The twin brothers, wherever they are. Where are you performing next?
Yeah. I have to say, I don't know if y'all are church-going people. You don't look like a bunch of church-going people. But Matt is the musician in charge of the music at First Presbyterian, just around the corner. Now, we in the Mansion House, we live right behind this church. So if you live in the back of the building, you might hear like rock and gospel show going on every Sunday morning. That is, Matt is responsible for that. And it's, what time is the service?
11.
It's 11 o'clock. If you are doing nothing on, if you're just wandering around a Sunday morning, I suggest you wander in and get some old time religion. It is the best musician, some of the best musicians in New York, every Sunday, free. Unlike today, which is not free. But thank you so much for supporting this. I know, but when Michael asked me, I was like, I feel like these people have heard me sing so many times for free. It's funny to ask people to like write a check. But it is a wonderful cause. Alzheimer's is a horrible disease. And my voice teacher of many, many years, I worked with Fred Martell for, oh gosh, like right when I moved to the city. We worked together for 30 years. And he had Alzheimer's for many years, and I don't think he realized it, and it was just something that kind of crept up on him. And fortunately, he has family in Arkansas that could take care of him, but it's just a terrible thing where he wakes up every day. When I talk to him on the phone, I say, have you seen your sister? He goes, I don't think so. Have you been doing anything? I don't think so. And she says, we go to the symphony every week. We see him every day, but he doesn't remember. It's like every day is Groundhog's Day.
Yeah.
Anyway, it's just terrible. I try not to make Alzheimer's jokes, but I remember that during the pandemic, the Alzheimer's Association asked me to create some media content, and I've been singing the song "Try to Remember" a lot. And I thought, is that in bad taste? To sing "Try to Remember" for people with Alzheimer's? Just kidding. Anyway, I decided not to do it tonight. See, she got my Alzheimer's joke. You gotta laugh, people. All right, listen. First of all, I want to say once again thanks to my friend Marcy Chapin, who encouraged me to start in this. This has been a wonderful part of my life. I've done almost 300 concerts in here and for my friends and where my mom was living. And these are Ellen and Al. Say hi.
Hi.
They came in from Westchester. Yay. At the same time I was doing concerts in front of the Mansion House, I was doing them right in front of their house, and Ellen sang with me many times, and Al played with them. So maybe next time you come in, you'll bring your banjo, okay? We'll work it out. They got stuck in traffic. But thank you for making it here. This is a song that, and I wanted to say that the reason we started doing this was to thank our healthcare workers, and I want us to always remember that. So could you please bring a little 7 o'clock applause for the top seven, it's 6:36. And I want to bring in the song, this is a song by Jason Robert Brown. He wrote it, I believe, right after the 2016 election, and it was his response to that election, and it's really a song about working through something difficult. It's called Hope. I've sung it many, many times. It means so much to me, and every time I sing it, people are like, I needed that. I think that it never goes out of style. We always need hope about something, and this is an arrangement that my colleague, Mike Raya, did, and we're doing it for the first time with flute, all right? Is that, can you just check to see if your flute sounds going into the mic? Should it be on the other side?
No.
Is that, where's the sound come out?
Sound sort of comes out.
Let's do this. What do you think?
I just want to listen to you, so I'm not worried about
I think that's good. All right. This is Jason Robert Brown's Hope. Came out here to sing a song, so here I go. I guess I think that if I tinker long enough, one might appear. And look, it's here. One verse is done. The work's begun. I come to sing a song.
in spite of everything ridiculous and sad. Though I'm beyond belief depressed, confused, and mad. Well, I got dressed. I underestimated how much that would take. I didn't break until right now. I sing of hope and don't know how. So maybe I can substitute strength, because I'm strong enough. I got lots of things I didn't think I could, and so did you. I know that's true. And so we sing a song about hope. Though I can't guarantee there's something real behind it, we have to try to show our daughters we can find it. And so today, life is crazy and impossible to bear. It must be there. Fear never wins. That's what I hope. See, I said hope. The work begins.
Pandemic, there were all city sing-alongs. There was a Friday night that everyone was supposed to sing Frank Sinatra's New York, New York. And then there was a month later, everyone was supposed to sing Liza Minnelli's New York, New York. Now, Liza originated the song in the film with Bob De Niro. And then Frank Sinatra kind of stole it from her. He sort of took it on, became his signature tune. I saw Frank Sinatra do this at the reopening of Carnegie Hall, which is like in 1990. And I was sitting in a box next to Leonard Bernstein and Frank Sinatra, these New York legends. Anyway, we are going to close it out. If you feel excited about this tune, I encourage you to shimmy, do a kick line, whatever you want. Let's bring it in. Thank you so much, Mike, for having us. Oh, and also, I am appearing here pretty regularly on, next time I'm here is November 1st, which is just in 2 weeks, on Friday at 4. Usually we're here Friday at 4. And if you were interested in more about what I'm doing, look at songsfromtheledge.com or peterkendallclark.com. You can see what other upcoming things I have. I'm actually singing at Carnegie Hall. Should I tell you I'm singing at Carnegie Hall?
Yes,
November 23rd. It's a holiday concert, the music of Eric Whitaker. He's conducting also. I did it 2 years ago. I have a very small part, but it's a beautiful concert. November 23rd, 7:30, I think. Check it out. Shall we?
Yeah.
Start spreading the news. Sing it over and over. And the night we graduated, we came to the bar and it said, must be 35 to enter. We were shut out. We kind of ruined it. Listen, we have one encore no one asked for. I call these the encores no one asked for. Rebecca, would you come back? Come back for one. A little Barbara and Judy for you. Here you go.
Get your troubles. Come on, get happy.
Saw you again.
You better change.
Sky above.
Across the river, soon our cares will all be gone.
jolly